Hi guys, in this video I'm going to talk about data warehouse features. So basically there are main four features of data warehouse that are subject oriented, integrated, time variant and non-volatile type of data. So now let's start with first subject oriented. Data warehouse data is subject oriented. How it is subject oriented? Data warehouse is subject oriented because it provides information about a subject rather than organizational ongoing operations. These subjects can be product, customers and revenue, etc. So when we are talking about subject oriented, in data warehouse we can store the data particular to one subject. Like if my subject for a restaurant is customers, what are the total number of customers that visited in my restaurant, and I can divide this customers in different subjects. Like my subject can be vegetarian restaurants, vegetarian customers, non-vegetarian customers. So I have divided my data into a subject called customer, where I can get what is the number of customers that are vegetarian and what are the customers that are non-vegetarian. Also my subject can be product. How my subject can be product? Just like the example in restaurant, product is my food. So now the subject can be food. How the subject can be food for a restaurant? Like which type of food I am selling the most, like Indian food I am selling the most, or Chinese or continental. And apart from this, which stock for the particular food is getting less. Suppose my sell in the Indian is too high and at every night my stock gets down for Indian, but my stock for continental do not get too much used. So data warehouse subjects can be, data warehouse data can be more subject oriented. How it is subject oriented? Like my subject is product. So now from the product, like I said, Indian food is sold most in my restaurant. So my data can be based on different subjects. My subjects can be customer, product or revenue. Second, integrated. Data warehouse is constructed by integrating data from heterogeneous sources such as relational database, flat files, etc. I can store my operational data or data in DBMS, or I can have flat file system. So data warehouse is integrated of operational data, flat files, or if I having some different database systems, like if I'm storing data in files or registers or in traditional methods, then I can also integrate the complete data in data warehouse. So data warehouse is complete combination, or you can say integration, of operational databases, flat files or traditional files. So data warehouse is integration of different type of data sources. Now coming to the third feature, that is time variant. Data collected in a data warehouse is identified with a particular time period. Data in data warehouse provide information from historical point of view. So data in the data warehouse is a time variant. How it is time variant? Just like in the example of restaurant, I can collect the data when my restaurant was open, from opening to the 3 years, and after 3 years to the next 3 years. I can see that my sale in the first 3 years was more, and in the next 3 years my sale was less. So this will, I can collect the data based on different time variants. Like I can collect the data of particular seasons. Like I can collect the data of summer, I can collect the data based on the winter or in the season winter or for the season rainy. And from this time variant data, I can take out the different information which I need to, which is needed for me. So data in the data warehouse is time variant. It is time variant as different data for different periods can be collected. It can be collected for 5 year periods or for particular week or for particular year. So data in data warehouse is time variant. Fourth, data in data warehouse is non-volatile. So what is non-volatile? Non-volatile means data is not erased when new data is added to it. Unlike operational database, in which data is changed frequently, because if I am maintaining the data of my workers, then after 5 months my data of workers is going to change. But in data warehouse, I can have the collection of 5 years of what are the employees that I have. So data in the operational database do not change frequently. Why do not change frequently? Because we need the collection of data. Now if we don't have that bigger amount of data, then how we can analyze that? In the suppose for a restaurant, if we analyze that what are the number of employees in the food, in the service section has left the company, or what are the number of employees has left the cooking section of the company. So data in the data warehouse is non-volatile. It is a collection of data. The data do not change so frequently. Why do not change so frequently? Because if it changes so frequently, then we will be not able to analyze the data. And we kept the data in data warehouse so that we can analyze it, and it will help the organization or company. Operational database is kept separate from data warehouse, so frequent change in operational database do not affect the data warehouse. Our operational database are stored in one particular area and data warehouse is kept in different area. Why? Because operational database is going to change frequently, and this change in the operational database should not affect the data in my data warehouse. If I am changing the menu of my restaurant depending on the months, but my operational database should not affect the data warehouse data, as what is the total menu I am having or what is the total menu I am selling for a particular year, because I can analyze that this type of menu was, if I have made the menu rate high, then was I getting much profit, or if I am lowering the menu rates, then I am getting more profits. So operational database can change frequently, and it is kept separate from the data warehouse, as the change in the operational database should not affect the data in the data warehouse. So these were the main four features of data warehouse. If you like this video, then please like, comment and subscribe. Thank you.